Subscribe now and press the bell icon. Never miss an update.
Myself Sangeeta Devi from GK Jain School Raipura. To have a more update on our educational videos, you can subscribe to our YouTube channel GK Jain School. And if you like our videos, you can just like on it.
In today's class, we are going to see about the 11th Standard Commerce Unit 2, Objectives of Business. It is a new chapter we are going to see in today's class. In the last few sessions, we have completed the Unit 1. In today, we are going to see about what is the main objectives of the business. Before learning about the objectives of the business, we have a lot of things to be known that we are going to see in this chapter. What are the things you will learn when you complete this unit is you will know about the meaning of human activities and its kinds, and you will be knowing about what is the economic activity and non-economic activity, and you will be knowing about the different types of the economic activities. Under the categories, you will be having three categories: employment, profession, business. You will be learning about these different words, meanings in this chapter. And you will be knowing about the understanding about the concept of business. What is the concept of the business? And you will learn about the characteristics of the business activities. And you will know about the objectives of the business. And you will learn about the business, profession and employment. So this much of the different things you will learn when you complete this unit. So it is a very easiest chapter, and also different concepts in the business you will learn in this chapter. So in today's class, we are going to start with the human activities. In today's session, you will be discussing about these three topics: what is human activities and what are the examples we can give for that. And you will learn about the human activities kinds, and you will learn about economic activities and non-economic activities. So before going on to this chapter, what is the activity? Something you are performing, that we tell it as an activity. So you should know about the general meaning of each words whenever you learn. Then only you can understand when the examples or the theory content which is you are coming across. So first we learn about the human activities. What is human activities? So human activities, I have given in the three bullet points. It is a one single statement, but I have given you for your easy understanding. I have given the three bullet points. First one is the activity performed by human being. Activity is what? Activity is something, an action performed, an action, something you're doing. So here, activity performed by human being. So for in the word itself, you can understand something, a work or an action, something done by the humans. So that is what is the meaning of the human activity. So human activity is nothing, it is very simple activity which is going to be performed by the human being. Next we have is the second point, to meet his needs or wants. So to meet his needs or wants, what is needs or wants? What is our necessity? What is our thing which we need at present or want? What do we like? Wants is something which we like or desire or our wish. We can tell it as a want. So to meet our needs or the wants, we are doing some activity. Daily we are doing some day-to-day activities to meet our wants. If let me take it off, I am watching a television. Okay, simple example I'm giving you. I'm just watching a television. It's my, what it is giving me some relaxation, or I'm something doing on that is I'm watching television. So I'm performing some activity. So it is performed by a human being only. So next is something, it is to meet my needs or wants. I want to watch a movie is my wish. So I'm to meet my needs or wants, I'm doing that activity. Or next, otherwise it may have the personal satisfaction. Personal satisfaction is what? You will be having some fulfillment. Whenever you are doing some activity, you will be having some fulfillment of the work. So whenever you are having that fulfillment of the activity is something, whenever you are doing for your wish or your want or a desire, then you will be having that personal satisfaction. Let me take it off. I am just watching a movie, it's watching a television itself, the example. So to have the personal satisfaction, whenever I watch the television, I will be having some relaxation. It is not with the television, it can be with watching a movie in the theater. something, whatever the activities which I am doing, it, let me just take it a simple example. I'm cooking a food for my family. Then what is happening over here? When I cook a food for my family, I have some personal satisfaction that whatever the food I am cooking, all my family members are going to have that, and that fulfillment I'll be having. So that is what is the personal satisfaction. To have the personal satisfaction, I'm doing some activity. So there is an activity to meet my wants also I can do, or to have the personal satisfaction also I can do some activity. If you see, I want to become a chartered accountant, let me take it. For fulfilling my dream, I just do some activity regularly. I'll be giving a spending time for my studies. And I go for the institute or the class for attending the coaching classes for this. So I'm doing some activity to fulfill my dreams. So that is also the human activities. So the human activities is very simple. Whatever the activities which is going to be performed by the human being to have what? Personal satisfaction or to meet his wants or desires. It is on a continuous paragraph or a theory, we can tell. I just want you to give in an easier way, so I have given the bullet points. So human activity is very simple. It's going to be an activity performed by the human being. So whatever the work you are doing, it is not only with the cooking a food for family or watching a movie in the theater. It can be of the doing some work for the other peoples also. What is it, other people, what the work you are going to do? See, I have a shop, okay, let me take it off simple, some more like small example. I have a retail shop or a small shop. For the shop, I am selling all my goods. I have a stock of goods in the shop. I have a whatever all the items required for the retail shop or wholesale shop, it can be different. So I have a plenty of goods in my shop. I'm selling all those goods to the customers. There also I have some satisfaction. Personal satisfaction I have. I'm giving all my goods and I'm earning a money. So there also I have some satisfaction. That is also a human activity. So whatever the work you are watching, let me take it off, you're doing exercise or doing a yoga at your home, you're doing. What for you're all doing? To have a physical fitness and also to have some what satisfaction that I'm regularly doing the exercise so that I'll be fit. So I'll be having some satisfaction and I'm also meeting my needs. Whatever my needs, I'm fulfilling. So this is what is about the human activities. So you all have understood that human activities is activities which is going to be performed by the human being. What? To meet his needs or wants and also to have the personal satisfaction. Now we are going to see about the human activities kinds. See, the human activities will be under the two topics, or we can tell it as the two kinds. Okay, one we can tell it as an economic activity, another one is the non-economic activity. So the human activities are now broadly classified into two categories. We have a subcategories also. So now human activities, we have two things. One is the economic activity, other one is the non-economic activity. Let me see about what is economic activity in examples, and then we will go for the non-economic activity. So we have know about the kinds also. Economic activity. So I have given the theory and the example. Likewise for the non-economic also. So it will be easier for you to understand. First we will see about economic activity. Whatever the activity which your human beings are going to be performed is common for both economic and non-economic. Okay. So whatever the activities which is going to be performed with the object. What is that object which is our motive or a goal? Okay, so with the object of earning of money, okay, whatever the work I'm doing with the motive of earning of money, that all comes under the economic activity. Okay, whatever work I'm going to do with the motive of earning the money, then it is an economic activity. Now let me see about the example so that you will understand in a better way. First we will take it off a small example, a manufacturing unit, okay, let me take it off, manufacturing unit, they manufacture lot of goods, okay, let me take it off a newspaper also, daily there will be a lakhs of newspaper will be manufactured. So there is a production of the goods now by the manufacturer. What is their motive? They want to sell all the newspaper to the public and they want to earn a money. So there is a motive of earning a money. So that is an economic activity. So whatever the activity which is going to be done by the human only, but with the object of earning money, then we will tell it as a economic activity. Now here I have given you is the selling by retailers. Yes, that is a small shop retailers. Where you learn in the 11th standard chapter class commerce itself, you will be learning a separate unit for the channels of distribution. There you will come across the producer, wholesaler, retailer, consumer and customer. In the very beginning of the classes, I have made the differences also in my video. So you can go through that so that you will understand in an easier way. So retailer or who? Who is a retailer? There is a small shop. From the wholesaler, they get the goods and they sell it to the customer. So who knows the taste and preference? Here who knows? Retailer only obviously knows. Whatever the food it is going to be prepared by the your families, your mother, let me take it if your mother is preparing a food. Then your mother knows what is your taste and what is your preference, what food you will eat. Everything is known by your mother. Likewise, the retailer only here knows about all the taste and preference of the customer. Let me take it off. You're going to a small shop where you buy a notebook. Regularly, 1 month once or 2 months once you go and buy. Then obviously the retailer will be knowing you. And whenever you go and ask for a note, he will pick up the what note you prefer. He knows the taste. So now what is the main motive of retailer? Now he wants to fulfill your needs. What is your needs? He wants to fulfill. He knows his taste, so he buys from the wholesaler and keep it in this available in the shop, and he sell it to you for what? For the money. So here is also an object of earning a money plays a role. Now next we have few more examples. Let you tell me so that you can understand in a better way. Doctor, okay, let me take it off. For some medical advice is going to be given by a doctor, okay, or some physicians or some person who is going to render the service of medical advice. Then for that there is going to be a consultation piece. So with the object of earning a money only, they are doing that. Next we take it off, a chartered accountant, okay, he is going to have the accounting practice. In that situation, what it is going to be? With the object of earning a money only, he will be doing the accounting practice. Next, we go for the wholesaler. From the producer, he gets the goods and sell it to the retailer. With the motive of what? Earning a money. So, everywhere there is a motive of a money, then it comes under the economic activity. We can easily classify that. Other than this, whatever you have will be a non-economic activity. That we will see about the definitions and the examples so that you will understand that non-economic activities also. So non-economic activity is something, it's going to be an activity which is going to satisfy the social needs or psychological needs. What is the social needs or psychological needs? So I'm doing some work, with that I'm going to have my personal satisfaction. Okay, I'm going to have my personal satisfaction. And as well as I am going to fulfill my friends or relatives or family's needs also, I am going to fulfill. But without an objective of earning a money. Here there is no way the object of earning money will be involved. So activity whichever you are going to perform, which is not going to be the object of earning a money, that it comes under the non-economic activity. And obviously to satisfy the social or psychological needs. That is my personal needs or my friends or my relatives or family's needs which I'm going to fulfill. With that, I'm going to have the personal satisfaction. So this is also an activity which is going to be performed by the humans. So non-economic activity is very simple, which is not going to have the object of earning a money and it is going to satisfy the social needs. Let me give you a few examples so that you will understand this also in an easier way. Cooking, here I've given you is a cooking food for family. So, or daily your mothers or a father will be preparing a food for you daily in the home. And one day you plan that, okay, let me go and cook for my family members. When you go and cook, you will be obviously having the personal satisfaction. Not only the personal satisfaction you will have, you will, rather than this, you will be having the fulfillment. Your mother will be telling you, you have prepared the food good and you like that cooking most. And you will be feeling that, okay, again and again I should cook for my family and give. So that are the different good thoughts that will be coming to your mind. And not only this, you will be having some other examples. Festivals, okay, let me take it up. Festivals, we are celebrating with our family members. So we have a different festivals which we are celebrating in a year. So whatever the festivals I'm celebrating, I'll be having the enjoyment and the excitement with my family. I'm spending and I'm going to with my friends, I'll be spending that day. So I have a lot of personal satisfaction. Okay, so that also we can tell. And in the very beginning I have told you about the human activities example. Doing a meditation or a yoga or a exercise, that all gives me only a personal satisfaction, or my want or my desire is to do that, I'm doing that. Or I can give you a watching a movie in a theater also. I go with my neighbors or a friends, with the families, and I have a lot of excitement and spending the whole day with them. I have a lot of personal satisfaction and I satisfy the social needs also. So that is what comes under the non-economic activity. So here economic activity will be broadly classified into many types, where I told you in the very beginning what are the things you will learn in this chapter. There I have mentioned about the business, employment, profession. That all comes under the economic activity only, because all these things which will be a motive of what? Earning a profit. So that is the non-economic activity. When I go for the non-economic activity, we don't have that much of a broad classification and all. Where it we will be having it in the differently. We will be seeing that economic activity and non-economic activity classifications in the upcoming classes.
Thanks for watching.